Hi there. Do you know that you require a license to fly a kite or a balloon in India? Sounds strange, isn't it? Well, laws are sometimes stranger than fiction. My name is K.P. Singh, your chief mentor for law, and I welcome everyone to IMS Gets at Law. The Aircraft Act of 1934, which empowers the Union government to make provisions for the control of the manufacture, possession, use, sale, import and export of aircrafts, and contains some loosely drafted sections which lead to this bizarre situation. For example, Section 2, Subsection 1 defines aircraft as any machine which can derive support in the atmosphere from the reactions of the air. Thus, it can include airships, flying machines, gliders, kites, balloons, even for that matter, Kim Kardashian's or Ganesh Acharya's bottom. Government is also empowered to impose license requirements, they can impose tariffs, they can even create rules to control aerodromes. Now, what is an aerodrome? The place where you park your flying machine. So in my case, it will be top shelf of my almira where I keep my stack of kites. Section 7 of the Act empowers the government to investigate any accident involving these flying machines. So therefore, now my neighbor Bunty should be prosecuted and jailed for looting my kites, dozens of kites every year. I think government should use Section 8 and confiscate all his flying machines, that includes all his balloons and kites. All of this sounds so bizarre, isn't it? Well, thankfully, this law has never been implemented in its true letter and spirit. And therefore, you can still keep on flying your balloons and kites without worrying about the consequences. If you like this video, like, share and subscribe. Don't forget to ring the bell icon so that you keep on receiving timely notification about our new content. Thank you so much.